This is a historic first time. We have 50 states for the deaf grassroots movements. Thank you for coming. I am Scott. I am Conway from PR. We've worked very hard teamwork with Rob Pawnee from New York, Rochester. And the whole team has been great. We've been working for months. And so now I hope that you all will show, scream out for this. Do it. Show your signs. Why are we here? We're here to ask the legislature, Rob Pawnee, here. Wow. Deaf grassroots movement means that we're going to be working for education to it. Now remember, the deaf grassroots movement, this is the sign for it. These are the roots down below. This is the grass up above. That's, no, you can't have one without the other. They die. So we need you all to cooperate together. Grassroots movements, all of us. Many people. All people. Grassroots meeting was set up a while ago for civil rights. All these people have had their rights. Civil rights, women's movement, people of color, and finally now, 2016, well, 2015 we set it up, for deaf rights. September 15th last year, we all went to D.C. and rallied there. After we left, we decided we need more. We weren't satisfied with us. So we set up the deaf grassroots movement to spread it through all 50 states. And it's perfect you're all coming here. So thank you. Now, deaf grassroots movement is taking up a national rally. It's grassroots has taken over from the bottom up. Everyone's coming here to show your spirit to the state, to the senators, to the House, to everyone in the legislative office right above us. They can look down and see.
You gotta be ready at any moment, right? And so I am thrilled to see everybody here today. You are part of our historic event. We are here to communicate with the people at our state capitol. There are people who've gone to Washington, D.C., to our nation's capital. We are tired of the barriers. We are ready for access. We've had enough, and so we are here to tell you that we are capable people, of course. Come on. We have struggled for too long. Enough is enough, and we are here to say we can do anything. I can talk about my own story, my own experiences in both the hearing and the deaf world. The deaf world is my life. If not for that, I would be out, completely out. Because of the exposure that I got to the deaf world when I was 6 years old, the support I've seen, the opportunities to overcome barriers. Without the deaf community, I wouldn't have made it where I have. And because of that, I've been able to go into the hearing community. I now have a television show. I've provided interviews with hearing people who've come to talk to the deaf community through my program. And we know there are so many barriers out there. We know it's difficult to get quality interpreting services, and we have to work. Other people have done the work and surpassed us, and because of these barriers, we are prevented from reaching our full potential. So I know that based on your experience, I'm sure you've had similar frustrations and anger, and so we are. I am tremendously grateful to the Deaf Grassroots Movement, because DGM has started something that is going to continue, and I am grateful not only to DGM, but also the Empire State Association for the Deaf, who's also represented here, and to you. We are standing here in front of our state capitol, the site of many important events, of significant work. Across from us is the legislature, also the site of rulemaking, policy making, and whatnot. So we have a bill in process to be proposed to the legislature. We expect that they're gonna hear us and see us today.
How do you move down?
If we don't make our needs known, they won't pay attention to that bill. We are here to make sure they see and hear us and know what it is we demand. The legislative process is a bit odd. This rally will help encourage them to pass the legislature that we're suggesting. If not from this rally, myself, my name is Tanya Ingram, and I'm the chair of the House of Justice, the Deaf Club there. Hello, my name is Opal Gordon, and I'm also from New York City. I'm a member of the House of Justice Deaf Club. So we'll give you a sense of what we've been doing. So what are we here for today? We're here for deaf rights. We want communication access. We want education equality. And we want deaf jobs. We say CEJ, communication, education, and jobs. What kind of equality do we want? Well, deaf people have been frustrated at the tremendous unemployment that deaf people face because of discrimination. And what else do we want? People here at this rally have waited too long. We will not wait any longer. For the past 150 years, there have been no improvements to communication access.
No!
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 Why do we want access to voting? Well, we can vote. How many of you? That's what we need. You need to talk to your communities, because when hearing people use their power to vote, we need to do it too. We can improve our access by using your power to vote. So when you go back home, make sure people are registered and ready. Opal, why do we need quality education? We need to have language access in education. American Sign Language has an important part in education of deaf children. We have a right to Why do we need to talk about employment? Well, like I said before, there's 75% of the deaf community is unemployed. These are people who want jobs.
That's fine.
Too often we see our hearing counterparts advance in their careers, and we don't have that kind of opportunity because of communication access and the need for interpreters is a big problem, and we've had enough.
We do not accept these things that we haven't been given. We have what we need, all of our, what we want to have done. We need jobs. We need to let them know, where are our jobs? Where are they? We also need improvement in education for our children. They're behind. They've lagged behind in language. We have to let them know that they have to improve school education in New York State. We have to let them know that. Come on, we've had enough. Also, communication in the hospitals.
Yes.
This has been put off. They don't have interpreters. Interpreters don't arrive. They have VRI, remote relay, remote interpreters, not working, VRI. This is no good. And again, we have to let the school departments know that we need interpreters for mainstream schools. And they need to be given the opportunity to go to deaf schools to have a choice of going to deaf school if they'd like to. So, they don't know anything about deaf education. They don't know about deaf schools. So, they have to... Okay. And just recently, the House of Justice had voted that we must have a rule of voters.
Oh!
Go to meetings. The legislature, the first question they ask is, you know what they want to say? Who are the registered voters? That's what they ask. They always ask that. If you're not registered, they don't listen to you. You have to go home. The House of Justice just said this. You have to have registered voters to say enough already. NED is always famous for saying what? Nothing about us without us. Nothing about us without us. Yeah. Yeah. Emphasize to you, the Grassroots sign, some of your... That's a spider. Don't make a spider. You have to make an actual deaf Grassroots sign with the grass up and roots down, okay? They said that sign is very important. To have the deaf Grassroots sign, okay? And have, don't have like a cute little expression on your face. Come on! Yeah.
This is heartbreaking. Not my sign.
Did it!
And the use of the term non-persons. There was a Greek philosopher named Aristotle in ancient history who had a theory that if somebody couldn't hear, they couldn't learn. And many people believed that theory for thousands of years. And they even required deaf people to identify as non-persons. And they had no rights. And that lasted for many, many years. I got a jury summons. And on the back of the paper, it said, if I need assistance, there's a number to call. So I called and said, yes, I need sign language interpreting services. Now, this was 2 days before my jury service date. And they told me they would have an interpreter ready. So I took time off my job. And I showed up where I was supposed to with everybody else who was serving jury duty that day. They had a video that wasn't captioned about your jury service. So I went up to the office where the commissioner was. And they actually kind of made me feel a little bit bad because they called me out in front of everybody. And when I got up to the office, they just opened the door and said I should leave. But I asked about the interpreter because I had called twice to make arrangements for interpreting services and they told me that no interpreter was available. I said, but, and they said, you could just go, you could go. That made me feel like a non-person. I went home and I called a company that provides interpreting services. They never even got a request from the courts. Nothing. So I wrote a letter to Albany, to my representative here, about the courts. And they apologized. They said they'd look into it. But that was 25 years ago. And nothing has changed. I still feel like a non-person. And so we all are considered non-persons in this regard.
I have gone to the hospital many times because I'm in a wheelchair. I've had many surgeries. And they said, oh, there's no interpreter. There's no interpreter. So we have to get the video remote interpreter on the screen. And I'm not happy with VRI. I want a live interpreter there. And they said, well, but there aren't any available. There are none available. So they brought me the video remote interpreting. And if I stayed in the hospital for a long time, they would bring a live interpreter with the doctor. They're like, but this isn't fair. It's an emergency room, it doesn't matter. So I waited and waited. And we really need more interpreters.
Hello, New York. I'm Carl Gordon. And I suggest that we need to be strong. Don't be afraid. Remember, God is with you. God is always with you. He has made you bright, intelligent people. We are deaf and so be strong. Stand up for what you need, and we will overcome. We will not lose if we are strong. So speak up for what you want. Don't be afraid. We are intelligent people. When we look at history, we know that God has been with us throughout history. The Bible proves that God is with us. Deaf or hearing, God does not discriminate. And so, with God's support,
I tried to get this at a Christmas party.
Yeah.
And to get a bonus and get commission. And I knew nothing about this. I just kept working, but they kept adding things on and taking things out of my paycheck. And I said, what is this? I got one check. How did they get two checks? How did you get that? That's a bonus. I never got a bonus. What are you talking about? This is what's supposed to be included. And so I went to HR and said, aren't we all supposed to get this? I'm the only deaf person who didn't get that. And they said, we don't know what happened. It's like thousands of dollars. And I never got this commission. I never got this bonus. They said, I'm sorry. So I just left. Forget it. I left and found another job. That's a problem. You have to take care of your pension. You have to be careful of what it is HR has, because they might hide things from you and have barriers against you. Go ahead and fight.
My name is Frances Kims. I'm from Rochester, New York. And I want to give thanks to my father. He was a hearing man, and he told me that we pay taxes for a reason. Even I was a young boy, he taught me that we pay taxes, and that covers things like our houses, our jobs. These are all ways that we end up paying taxes, and we vote for the people who decide how to use that money. So now I wonder, if these people are getting all the taxes that we pay, what are we getting? Part of history. I want to be with you and fight. We want to show some of the problems that have happened. My nephew is hearing, and I've got a hearing child. I went to the hospital and needed some help for a cut on my arm because I had fallen. It was an accident. And so we decided I needed to go to the hospital. And once we got in there, you know, because of so much blood loss, I wasn't quite in my right mind. I wasn't really able to understand clearly. I was already kind of nervous, and I had all these doctors and nurses coming around me. And I know they were all there to help me, but still, I was kind of nervous, and I was having a hard time understanding that. And my daughter told them, look, we need to get an interpreter. She told the doctor, she told the nurses. They took them off to jail and left me in the hospital with no interpreter. We had to go to court and fight to say, look, we need better support services for deaf people. All this could have been avoided. We need to be here at the state Supreme Court and in other places around the state to make sure that there are laws put in place to support our needs. We need interpreters, and still, we can't have interpreters. My nephew ended up in jail, and I want to support him because I was so upset at what happened. We weren't able to understand what was going on in the medical situation with the police. My daughter was trying to figure things out and help me understand what she thought was going on.
Yeah.
She was signing really small, and I said, no, sign bigger. Make sure they know that we're using sign language.
I would talk, and I would work. I would use a TTY, and they tell me, no, you can't. And I said, what are you talking about? You're on the phones all the time. You're always talking on the phone. You never hang it up. You're talking to your friends. You're not talking about work. You're talking to your family. You're not talking about work. So the boss said, you know, this is okay for the hearing people to use their phones. Is that right? That was a waste of time. It was a waste of the government's money. But deaf people, wow, are good workers. You know you all are. You're good workers. And the hearing people just oppress you. Don't let that happen. You work well. You come here. You work hard at your jobs. You pay attention to your jobs. And deaf can do better than hearing do at work. But
2 years ago, there was no interpreter at a doctor's appointment. I had made that appointment 2 or 3 months ahead of time. So when I asked them, they didn't have any good excuse. Just last month, I had another appointment. I asked them, where is the interpreter? They still didn't have any good excuse. And I lost it. I tell you, I blew my stack. I wrote them a letter of complaint telling them that I have equal rights. I need to have a medical interpreter according to the ADA. And I sent that letter to the hospital in their human resources department. About a month later, I got a letter back. That letter said, well, we have VRI, we can provide interpreters when possible. Can you believe that? Deaf people need access to live outside interpreters. VRI doesn't work. It's not effective. I don't want VRI, I want a live interpreter.
You understand what they're saying? You understand what they're saying? No, not at all. We complain about it, and the hearing people are going wild. Yeah, yeah, go. So, where's the captions for the band? And I said, hey, what's the matter with you, interpreter? You should be doing ASL, because the deaf people need ASL. And one day before this performance, they rehearsed, and that was it. You should have been practicing over a long time ago. Hi, nice to meet you. What's the matter with you? The band was no good. One day before is no good. You need to be practicing for a month or two before to have the equal access that the hearing people have to the performance. And, oh, I'm sorry. Shame on them for that. At this point, with certification, they need to be approved. The NAACP have an organization through Martin Luther King, you know. Gay and lesbian, straight. Jewish groups have rights. All of these people have rights. And it has taken a very long time. And do things pass easily? No. Don't give up. Never give up until you get old.
Yeah.
Get old, yeah. Then if you're satisfied, once it passes, yeah. We have to do this for the children, not for us, for them. And we have to keep patient and keep working until this fills, until it touches that building over there, the Statue of Liberty. We have to pass all of these. We have to pass.
I'd like to talk about the children. Your grandchildren, your children that are going to schools for the deaf. Now we're seeing more and more where kids are being mainstreamed, being the only kids at a school of hearing children. But as these kids grow older, where are they going to get their needs met as a deaf person? How are they going to participate in sports, get their social activities done? Here in New York State, if I'm not mistaken, there are 7 schools for deaf, correct? 7? We're starting to see the numbers at these schools for deaf dwindle. They're getting smaller and smaller. So we need to keep fighting for that. Do not give up on that. As I grew up, I went to a public school, and I was in a school for hearing kids until I was 12. And much thanks to my mother realized that I needed to go to a school for the deaf. Had it not been for that school for the deaf, I would not be here today. I'd be a farmer or something like that. That's where I'd be. So I'm very, very grateful to the school for the deaf, and I would like New York State to keep growing these schools for the deaf. Not just one school, but all 7. Right? We have different schools in different parts of the state. Buffalo, Rochester, Rome, several in New York City, at 3 or 4 down there. So we need to keep these schools open and operating. We need to keep these deaf kids in schools for the deaf. It's important for the future, it's important for your children and your grandchildren. I have grandchildren as well.
Dr. Goodwin said cochlear implant. did that many, many years. And he did fine with his grades and in school. So lonely, so cool, so hard. When my son became 13, 14, he asked to go to deaf school. This past year, he started at Rochester School for the Deaf. He's so happy. Thank you for fighting for your rights.
Oh. They learn language. Deaf students
have all these different signs.
South America, they have one language. In Australia, they have one language for deaf children. America has all of these languages. It causes deaf children to not have communication and to be upset. We need one language. He asks if you don't mind to provide interpreters for the trip, for the deaf people to know what's going on for the tour guides. And I'm sorry, you have to pay for this yourselves. No, you give English. You have lots of translators. You have lots of people who use this for access when they travel so they can understand what's going on in the world. It's important to have this access. So some people approve it. Some people don't mind. But you have to use deaf sign language leaders to come from the local area. Use them instead of an interpreter. Support the deaf community who knows how to do this and who knows this. We're the same. We can use them as our tour guides and share our cultures. The deaf cultures between that. I want to see that more and more. And that's what I'm working on for the deaf company, for deaf tours. To cooperate with them to see if they have any deaf leaders so that we can support them 100%. Like, they were using deaf tour guides to come, and I've never experienced this before. It was from Cuba that they were people from Japan who grew up in Japan and lived there for a long time. We used them to be our tour guides. It was awesome. We want more of them.
What they're getting us? No. We've been here all day. We're here 10 in the morning to 4 at night. We're in the, talking to legislators. We're in the building. We're talking to state senators. We're talking to state assemblymen and state assemblywomen. We're speaking the chairs of committees. These are very intense meetings, and then we're actually speaking about education, employment, communication, and we're going through our talking points and giving them all this information of what we need. The meetings that I've been involved with, every single person is saying, oh yes, of course, how, what can I do, how can I get involved, where can we start some research, can we start a bill, can we get a law, can we get a proposal? So many people in New York State, have these people here have so much experience in lawmaking, and they're ready to sign, they're ready to support all of us. And then the law would be could be signed and passed right here, thanks to all of you. DGM, this is where it started. This is not about me, this is not about him. This is about all of us. We are all fed up with the status quo that started as when we were infants, a deaf child is born, and what do? We have to fix the child. Deaf, oh my goodness, we have to, let's give them the FM, let's get that box on their chest, let's do the cochlear implant, let's fix this problem, fix it. Let's go to speech therapy, we have to get this training, we have to fix it, we have to get this. But wait, where does language come in? Where does communication come in? That's to the wayside. It's all about this training, but where's AS? Finishes school, tries to get a job, but they need to pass certain tests and do such. It's like, for example, what Tim was saying recently. It's a P or a B. What does that sound like? It's not important. Oh, okay, go work to the school for the deaf. Go to work this school for the deaf. Just teach deaf children. But in New York, we don't have any of that. There's just this testing and this discrimination. It's just discrimination in regards to testing just can't happen. We don't have the language, we don't have the education. Job interview comes up, the interpreter's there, but we can't have an interpreter, interpreter's too expensive. So you have, we're hitting these roadblocks, and we're sitting back and having to get Social Security. No. Oh, you guys are lazy. I'm not lazy, the system is failing us. Yeah. We're trying to get in, we have these roadblocks we can't get past. You're talking about a $15,000 a year job, and you're cleaning. That's what we're being offered. We can do more than that. We're absolutely capable of more than that. Getting SSI, getting SSD. Okay, you're getting $17,000. Why am I going to clean for $15,000? I can stay home and get $17,000. Just hang out. Of course, people would rather do something like that. But again, because the system is broken, they're not helping us. There's no support, and the time is now. It's enough. An emergency comes up, we need an interpreter. Okay, there's VRI. Oh, this is an interpreter. But they're, an emergency comes up and there's an emergency state of the situation or something. You can't see the interpreter on the screen on the television. You're at a movie theater, you have to wear these stupid glasses on top of your regular glasses for 2 hours. So you have this horrible headache from all this accoutrement on your face. I mean, it's enough. Enough. Again, where's even going to a restaurant and we don't have this, we can't. It's again, we don't have caption on the TVs if we go anywhere. I mean, it's been 200 years and we're still having to deal with what we're having to deal with. We're not moving forward. DGM is saying we are fed up. Equally, we all understand ESAD is here, and we are going to keep going. DGM, thanks all of you. They're right. I saw your cameras in here. Times is here. Reporters already had interviews with certain news reporters. There's another article that's going to be published.
Okay.
Everybody should follow me. Come on, pat each other on the back. Pat each other on the back. You deserve it. All right. Good for you. So come again. Come again with us. So now, yesterday, last minute, they said, come on up here to go to a meeting with a legislator. So, okay. Because I'm a member of the Empire State Association for the Deaf, they said, come on, come over here. So I joined the first meeting, the second meeting, then a third meeting. It was a good experience. We got along, and they really seemed to listen. They really paid attention. So I told them my experiences, because my son is deaf. He went to school. Rochester School for the Deaf, then went to mainstream school with interpreters and had all these problems, and I decided to send him to MSSD, and he's happy now there at Gallaudet, Model Secondary School for the Deaf, right near home. So I'm coming to fight for our children.